Hi, this is Jason Chanka with Lakeshore Cryotronics. In this video, we're going to demonstrate noise rejection using an LED and a photodiode and a lock-in measurement technique. The lock-in technique is extremely powerful for rejecting noise, and the best way to illustrate that is a demonstration. So let's get back to the workbench and I'm going to dive right in. So in this demo, we've got, in our test fixture, we've got an LED, and that LED is being driven by a balanced current source. That's the BCS10. The M81 mainframe controls all of the modules. So we've got the BCS10 sourcing a current to the LED that's going to create photons, going to push light out. And then we've got a photo detector on the other side of the board, and that photo detector is going to create a photo current that is proportional to the amount of light falling on it. That current, it creates a photo current, and that's going to get pushed into our current input meter. And this is the CM10 current measurement meter. And then we've got this voltage output module to complete that particular circuit for the photo detector. We're not actually going to bias the photo detector in this case, but just consider it to be part of the circuit. But we're basically going to source current to a light LED that's going to create photons, and then we're going to measure the amount of photons coming into the photo detector using the current measurement module. So to start out, I'm going to do a DC source. So I'm just going to source a specific current, 1 milliamp, and turn that on. That's going to, again, start shining some light out of our LED. I'm going to turn on the voltage source to complete our circuit. And then I'm going to measure the photo current. So with this 1 milliamp into this LED, I've got around 30 microamps, 31 microamps of photo current. Now I'm going to take a simple flashlight and I'm going to shine it into the photo detector. And this is basically simulating noise. And you'll see I've got over 200 microamps now. And if I pull away the noise source, I drop back down to 30 microamps. Put the light source back up there. Oh, can't quite get it up to the 200 that I had. Oh, there we go. Back up to the 200 that I had there. And so this is saying if we've got a DC source and we're making a DC measurement, then a DC noise source can also create a lot of additional error from our measurement. One way that we can mitigate that, and a powerful technique to mitigate that, is to go to a lock-in technique. So in that case, we're going to change our source current from DC to a sine wave. And I'm going to, because we're dealing with a diode, the sine wave has a positive and a negative component around a zero. We're going to push an offset of 1 milliamp so that we can go above that. A negative current into a diode is going to have a very high voltage, so we need to set that offset up just a little bit. So I've got a 13.3 hertz sine wave at 1 milliamp peak to peak with a 1 milliamp offset going into the LED. And my LED is now flashing, yes. And now I am going to change my measurement over to a lock-in technique. And that lock-in mode now is locked into that 13.3 hertz reference signal from my source, my current source. And we're reading minus 22 microamps out of that, that particular photo detector. Now I'm going to turn on my noise source again. And I'm going to line it up just so. And you'll see now my photo current doesn't change at all.
So the lock-in technique is really powerful at rejecting DC noise sources, as we've seen, right? We've got the LED flashing at a specific frequency. Our large noise source, our large DC offset, is not even registered when we get right into the photo detector with the light. And this is very, very indicative of a lot of optical measurements. You'll actually have a chopper wheel, which will cut the signal, the light signal that's going in, and then that can be referenced to other instruments using cabling and reference outputs. The nice thing about the M81, it's all integrated into the instrument. So the M81 controls all of the references and can easily distribute the reference information across different measurement modules, which can be really powerful, especially if you're making more than one measurement. So I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you do want more information on the M81 or any of the measurement techniques that we've covered in this video, please go to Lakeshore's website, which is www.lakeshore.com.